Immunology Wars, the Battle with HIV. Hello, this is Mark Medicals with the latest on HIV cure news, HIV treatment, HIV symptoms, and all about HIV transmission. In this video, I will take you through how HIV attacks and beats your immune system to finally advance to the AIDS stage. This video is all about wars between your body's immunity and HIV infection. Alright, when a virus enters the body, the immune system normally responds with a fierce fight. Antiviral proteins are quickly released by white blood cells, which assault infected cells and recruit backup. Typically, this is sufficient, but HIV is one virus that pushes the immune system to its limits. HIV infects one of the immune cells responsible for the body's pathogen response. Helper T cells, or CD4 cells are the name for these cells. The virus binds and penetrates first, then drives its enzymes and genetic material towards the nucleus. Once inside, one of these enzymes, reverse transcriptase, converts viral RNA into a length of DNA that inserts into your cell's genome, causing the cell to release HIV proteins and genetic material, a process that helps the virus to replicate itself. These new viruses leave your CD4 cell and spread to infect others. HIV levels build quickly in the body, but the immune system does not surrender easily. Antiviral proteins, termed restriction factors, work inside infected cells to inhibit virus production while others prevent the virus from departing the cell. B cells are white blood cells that produce neutralizing antibodies that bind to the surface spikes on HIV particles and prevent them from reaching healthy helper T cells. Killer T cells and natural killer cells, which seek out and destroy infected cells immediately, are the most effective. They release a protein called perforin, which punches infected cells, allowing enzymes to be delivered and auto-destruction to take place. For a while the protection holds, and virus levels drop, but HIV initiates its counterattack. HIV inhibits the antiviral proteins in the cell, allowing fresh virus particles to enter. It also mutates frequently inside the cell to avoid detection. Because the immune system cannot fight what it cannot see, it gradually wears out. When killer T cells are active for an extended period of time, they get tired and no longer respond to infection. In addition, the body loses the ability to produce new helper T cells to replace those destroyed in the fight, and their numbers plunge as a result. Ultimately, the body becomes immunodeficient, and this illness is known as AIDS. Without treatment, exposure to otherwise harmless microbes can be fatal. We still don't know how to completely eradicate HIV from the body. There is no cure for HIV, and if the medicine is stopped, hidden reservoirs of the virus will resurface. Treatment with antiretroviral medications, on the other hand, can swing the balance, allowing the immune system to recover and fight another day.